Chances for job promotion, school admissions, immigration status, and personal reputation forever. And this was their pitch to me to try to hire them as my attorney. I've been getting tons of mail, man. Bam. Tons of lawyers have been in contact with me, but the case is closed, the case is dismissed, it's gone, it's done with. Alright, now, as everyone knows, that's been here, my subscribers, family, once again, I apologize for disappearing like that. Let me explain real quick what happened. 6 years ago, I had caught a dope case in Chicago, okay? Got caught with 9 grams, okay? I ended up getting probation, 2 years probation. I come back to Pennsylvania, alright? The extradition laws don't work the same with Illinois and Pennsylvania because Pennsylvania is a commonwealth state. Now, Pennsylvania will work with Virginia, Massachusetts, and Kentucky because those are commonwealth states. Otherwise, Chicago would have to come and get me, alright? In Pittsburgh, which they wasn't worried about me. The crime rate out there, dope cases out there, there's so many of them that I was just a petty little case, you know what I mean? 9 grams in Pennsylvania, I'd go straight to prison. In Chicago, they're like, ah, man, give him a slap on the wrist. It's his first time in trouble. Give him 2 years probation. So I come back to Pittsburgh and I go to prison. I do 4 years in prison in PA. I get out. Recently, I just traveled to Chicago. I got pulled over, okay? When I got pulled over, I gave my license. You know what I mean? They said I had my high beams on. My high beams weren't on. They ran my name. They said, yo, you Mr. blah, 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 you got a warrant. I was like, I got a warrant? I was like, bro, you see my ID? I'm from PA, man. I got a warrant out here. I just got out here. I'm in a rental. They're like, you got a warrant from da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I was like, what? Dude, I was sick. All right, so I go to the bank. I see the judge. And before I seen the judge, an attorney, a public defender, come over to me and was like, you ran from your probation. I was like, I didn't run from my probation. I was in prison in Pennsylvania. Check your dates. Get your facts right. I didn't run from my probation. I was in prison. I can't report if I'm in the penitentiary. So it took them about 2 weeks to get all the dates right. I go back to court, go back in front of the judge. They dismiss everything. Everything's gone. Case, well, not dismissed. They instead of reinstating my probation, they closed my probation. Time served, basically. Like I gave them their 2 years of paper. I was in prison for some of it. So they let me go. That's when I got out of jail in Chicago. I'll show you guys a video right now. I'll show you guys a video right now when I got out. I want to show you a couple things. And I'm going to have to do it through this, unfortunately. I can't screen record it because it's on this new phone. So, here it goes. There, guys, I call it. But I actually have a valuable lesson. Stay tuned because I have a lesson to teach somebody that might be going to prison. I can't pause this. So, we got to do it like this. Alright.
Chicago. Just got out. Motherfucker got shot right in front of me. So, I think we all know what that means, right? I'm staying.
Nah.
Where you go, man? You stupid motherfucking man.
Is this the right video?
Dunkin' Donuts. Whoa! Alright, man. We safe out here.
Oh. Hold on, guys. My bad. Now look at the top of that right there. That's where you see it. See it? On iPhones, it tells you where you recorded. Chicago, Kedzie Plaza. Kedzie Plaza. That's in the hood. Let me say that differently. When I got out of jail, got the rental, about to leave Chicago, and some dude had got shot in that area. I didn't see anything. Someone got shot right there where I was. Pretty bad murder scene. I ended up getting pulled over again. I got pulled over again. They were looking for someone. Ran my ID to let me go. I got pulled over again the day I got out. But, I want to show you guys something else real quick before we get this lesson in. This is what I did when I first got back to Pittsburgh. Check out what I ran into. You will never, it's unbelievable what I ran into. That ain't it. Wait a minute, is this it? This is it. Now, unfortunately, there's no volume, but check this shit out. Thanks, guys, for all the welcome backs. See that? I ain't gonna show the rest, but dude had the Freemason logo on his windshield, so I had to chase him down. I can't show the rest though. All right, 9 minutes in. Hopefully, you didn't leave because here's the thing. All right, I'm gonna let you guys hear this first. A prison beef carried over to the street for me. I'm gonna explain after you listen. I ran into this dude yesterday on the street. I recorded it. Okay, you can tell it's me. There's no video to it, but there's volume and you can hear. You guys know my voice. And anyone new listening right now would know. I'm gonna let you guys hear it first, and then I'm gonna tell the story. So, let's do it.
Yo, hold up, bro.
No video.
Hold on, I gotta rap with this, bro.
So, how do you start this story like this? So, a dude that you heard, okay, is in a gang called the Pill Kings, okay, PK, Pill Kings. It's a white boy gang. I'm not affiliated with them. I'm not in it. They are branched off from the Latin Kings, okay? It happened in the 90s, Pennsylvania prison. Latin King gave the green light to the white boys from Pittsburgh to start a gang called Pill Kings. White boy gang, it's the white boy gang in Pittsburgh, basically. It's a jail gang, though. It's a jail gang. In the streets, they're not really active. In jail, they're more active. I can't really say in the streets I see them doing much. And, you know what I mean? If anyone's catching feelings about it, I don't care. I'm cool with a lot of them. I got respect for a lot of them. But they're just not really active in the street. You hear their name in jail. Anyway, so dude's in the Pill King, all right? We're in prison. We're down Western. The wall before it closed. And everyone that wasn't supposed to know knew that I was the dude that had Suboxone in the jail. All right, I was one of the main dudes that ran the Suboxone little drug ring we had going on. I mean, I'm just keeping it real. Anyone down there will tell you that. You heard the recording right there. You know, whatever. It doesn't matter now. I was doing my thing through visits with Girly, and it don't matter now. Yeah, I mean, that's the past. It's over with. It ain't like they can come do anything to me now anyway. I was getting it. I was living comfortable, you know, money-wise. So, like I said, everyone that wasn't supposed to know knew that I was busting a move every visit. All right, so this dude comes to me one day. All right, he goes, Iggy, man. Mind you, I just met him in prison, don't know him from the streets, but he's a white boy from Pittsburgh. He's a white boy from my city. So, you know, of course I'm cool with all of them. He comes in my cell, comes right to my cell door, he says, Iggy, I need to do a favor. I need you to do me a favor. I'm like, what's up, bro? He's like, listen, Melsey got in his debt with the Crips. They swung it over to me, a gang member. Got in debt with the Crips, and the Crips put it on him. The Crips told him that if you don't pay us one Suboxone strip, we're going to kill you. And he's at my cell. He's like, bro, they're going to kill me, bro. They're going to kill me. They're going to kill me. They're going to kill me. Will you please, here's what he wanted me to do. He said, will you please give the shot caller one Suboxone strip and I'll send you to $50 Western Union. He said, I'm getting transferred tomorrow, though. I promise you, Iggy, I'll get it done. I'm like, oh, man. I'm like, I don't know, bro. What you mean you're getting transferred? Like, what do you mean you're getting transferred tomorrow? Like, I'm like, come on, man. I don't know about that. And he's like, Iggy, on everything I love, man, I would never, ever do that to you. Please just clear my debt for me. I will pay you. The shot caller from the Crips then comes up to my cell. Now, we were in an old style jail, okay, where there was tiers five high on each side. Five high, tiers went up like this, all right? Like, you could literally get thrown off the tier and hit the ground. Like, they went up five high. Oh, it was an old style jail. If anyone knows what I mean, it was like a dungeon. It's like a dungeon set. No cameras and shit. It's very, very oldest jail in Pennsylvania. Built in 1848. That's how old this jail was. There was no vents in the cells, no ventilation, no window. You don't have a window outside. You're just in a brick. Put it like this. This was prisoner of war jail for the Civil War. That's how this jail was built. So they come up from each side. You know, it's a balcony. It's only about this wide. Okay. They come up from each side on him like this at my cell door. They're both ready. Like, well, yo, what's up? What are you gonna do? Like, you gonna get us the money or not? And I'm like, I knew the Crip shot caller. I had done business with him before. So I'm like, twin. I'm like, hold up. I said, twin, what's going on, bro? Like, what happened with him? What's going on with them? He said, Melcy got a debt. You know what I mean? It goes on the next ranking of the Pill Kings. The highest rank has to pay it. Cause the dude was in the hole, right? And he was getting transferred. They owed him $100. Once the box should be $100. I was letting dude send me $50 and clearing his debt. I was giving him half off and clearing his debt so they didn't kill him. So I'm like, twin, what's going on? He told me what's up. I was like, listen, man, I got it. I'll take care of it, bro. Let him go. Let him live. They're ready to cut dude's head off, like, right there. Like, like I saved his life. I saved this dude's life. Dude, you heard right there. I saved his life. All right, so twin's like, Iggy, man, don't get involved in this if you can't pay it. If you take this debt, it's on you now. But he basically was saying to me that if I take that debt and I don't pay it, they're going to kill me or, you know what I mean, poke me up, whatever. And I'm not even affiliated with that gang. I'm not even affiliated. I'm not even Pill King. You know what I mean? I'm just me. In the jail, I do me, you know what I mean? I was like a single dude, like I do me. But it was a white boy from Pittsburgh, from my city, so I wasn't gonna do him like that, basically. I had it. I said, twin, I got it, bro. Bing, 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 pulled it out right there, threw it in a piece of paper, folded up the yellow paper, gave him a strip right at the door, right in front of dude. He goes, Iggy, man, thank you, man. I love you, brother. I got so much respect for you. I got you. My girl will be calling your girl. Send her $50. I'm going to send her $50. Hey, Rice, make sure that money hits my motherfucking pockets. Iggy, I got you. I never do you like that, right? Right? Remember that? Remember he said that, right? He said that, right?
You! Hold up, bro. That's part of it, and you fucked me over.
How the fuck you over?
You were supposed to send me money, though, bro.
Matter of fact,
forget that. What was the deal, though, bro? That you sent me the money, and I cleared it up for you, and they was letting you go.
No, yeah.
Yeah, you ain't sent it to me, bro.
That's he said you never paid him.
Oh, I paid you, man. I paid him right in front of you.
You believe that shit, man? I saved this dude's life. And he didn't send me the money. And then I seen him on the street. I seen him on the street at McDonald's yesterday morning. What's up, bro? What, you think I'm sweet? You think I'm sweet? Oh, you think I'm gonna clear this debt for you? You ain't gonna send me my money? Oh, what, you think I'm sweet? All right. Well, just so you know, I had to cut that off. I got that money. All right. He paid it right there. Now, here's the lesson, guys. Here's what you don't do if you're me in a situation. If you go to prison and you're ever in the situation, one, don't get in debt. Bloods and Crips run most jails. They're the deepest. They have the most people, usually. Don't get in debt with them. That's the dumbest thing you could do, is get in debt with a Blood Gang, Crip Gang, Gangster Disciple Gang, Latin King Gang. They will cut your head off, so don't do it. Don't get in debt in jail. That is the number one thing you don't want to do in prison, is get in debt. Don't, if you can't gamble, if you're a degenerate, don't do it. Gamble right. If you play poker right. Don't get in debt, because shit will pop off that too. I got mad poker stories. Like, poker, oh my god. Poker was my bed. Like, I got a lot of stories with poker. Don't get in debt. And two, learn a value lesson from me. If you were in my shoes in that situation, don't get involved. He's a white boy from the city. You got to tell him, bro, you got to handle that, bro. You got to handle that with your people. You got a gang full of white boys, a gang full of Crips, and you're getting me in the middle of it. That was my mistake. I should have put myself in that position. I didn't want him to die. I didn't want him to get stabbed right there in front of me, so I paid it off for him. He ain't give me the money. He got transferred to another jail. I see him on the streets. We handle it right there. But the lesson B is, don't do what I did. You got time right there. If you can't pay me right now, I can't help you, brother. If you can't pay me right now, I can't help you, brother. You know what I mean? Another lesson to learn is, don't sell drugs in prison like I was. I got a lot of stories. I'll come back with more stories about it. That, yeah, I lived comfortable. At the same time, I didn't. Because I had a lot of heat on me from security. Security's like the cops in prison. They're like the feds inside the jail. They watch you. I had a lot of heat from security. I had snitches telling on me. I had haters. And I had people who wanted to take my place. And then I had motherfuckers who wanted favors. Everyone wants a favor. Yo, can I get a front? Can I get this? Can I get that? Put a lot of heat on me. I'm not in no gang. I'm by myself. All I really had, I really had my back was my celly. And my celly was a go-getter, though. You know what I mean? He was one of the dudes that'll... put it like that. I was cool with dude because I was in with his people, because I was looking out. Of course, I look out for my celly. So, like, I was cool, but it still brought a lot of heat. My celly got transferred. Like, a lot of things happened from selling Suboxone in prison. I had a lot of drama come my way. I never got out. I had a max out. You know what I mean? I had a max out. That tells you right there I got in trouble. You know what I mean? I pissed hard. I had dirty orange. I was doing too much, man. Like, I was in the mix, and everything that you could do in prison, I was in the mix. I was doing too much. And that's another lesson right there to be learned, is you don't want to do too much, man. You don't want to be in the mix of everything, because I'm telling you, it brings haters, it brings snitches, and it brings people who want your spot. So lesson be learned, man. Don't ever clear someone's debt unless they can pay you right there. All right, much love, man. Iggy MB 579, Department of Corrections, Pennsylvania, ain't no joke. We got more to come. One love.